the word of God
for advancement.
Hallelujah. I see you advance in Jesus' name. I hear the Holy Ghost say, it is time for my people to laugh at the face of the enemy. Hallelujah. Because something is about to break open in your life. The day for rain has come. And like mighty showers, our lives are being flooded. Restoration come to you. Grace is given to you at this hour. Hallelujah. You arise in the strength of God, in the ability of God, and in the grace of God.
Good evening, church. You're welcome to this Bible study this evening. Hallelujah. I trust that God's grace is at work in every life here this evening. If you're happy to be in church this evening, can you give the Lord a clap offering this evening? Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Well, if you're watching online, this is an online service for Glory Pavilion Church, Benin City, Nigeria. And this evening, we're going to be having God's servant, Reverend Dr. Efe Obuke, share God's words with us. Hallelujah. I trust God that this season, though we have a lot of things happening around us, but we know for sure that God's word to us is for real. And as we apply ourselves to God's word, as it comes to us, we're going to see God continue to bless our lives and makes us stronger. Hallelujah. Before we hear God's word this evening, we're going to receive ministry from our sensational Pneuma Praise. And so with joy to Jesus, let's make them welcome this evening. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are you excited this evening? Rise up on your feet as we just declare God's word. We are ready for the word. The word of God is a light unto our feet and a light unto our path. So we choose the way of the Lord. I choose the way of the Lord. Can you say that this evening with me? I choose the way of the Lord. God's word is my life. God's word is my salvation. Hallelujah. Put those hands together. I choose the way. I choose the way of the Lord.
I choose the way.
I choose the way of the Lord.
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 I follow the path of my master.
I choose the way.
Follow the way
of the Lord.
Bless the Lord of my soul and everything that is within me. Bless the Lord of my soul. Oh, thank you, Jesus. We bless your name. Oh, lelebarabaso parakalebarimo. My soul arise and bless the Lord. Hey. Oh, I will sing like never, sing like never. Oh, my soul, yes, I worship your home.
Exciting time. Blessed be his name. Praise God. Can you smile at somebody this evening? Tell them, welcome to God's presence. Hallelujah. As we study God's word this evening, I know that something awesome will be happening today. Hallelujah. Blessed be the Lord's name. I'd like us to pray at this time. Dear Lord, thank you for making this moment possible for us. We know you are present here. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty there. And so we declare liberty here tonight. And Father God, give us insight, bring revelation, and let there be freedom. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. So we're going to be looking at God's word today, and I've been so excited about this evening because the Lord has put something in my heart that I believe is incredible. And today, I want to be sharing with you about the Word of God. It's like an X-ray of the Word of God. Hallelujah. That is awesome. You know, the Word of God is the most powerful tool in the universe, because everything we see, everything God has done, He's done that by the instrument of His Word. And so where the Word of God is, there is power there. So it's incredible. In fact, the entire creation, the entire universe is held together by the power of the Word of God. And that is why when I began to feel in my heart that I should begin to share on God's Word, I got very excited, because your life is about to change. Hallelujah. It's awesome. You cannot be the same again when you handle the Word of God. You can be. Praise God. Now, one of the things I've come to realize is that the Word of God is really something that, even though it is something we talk about all the time, the truth is that we understand it very poorly. I don't know why it's like that, because it looks like the things that are common are the things that we understand the least. Praise God. But we're going to look into God's Word, because God is about to release you into an amazing life. Praise the Lord. Now let's go to John chapter 1. And I want to read two verses there. John 1, let's see verse 1. It says, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God." Look at verse 3. "All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made." The truth is that, according to this text, that the Word of God has always existed, and God is His Word. Hallelujah. Any man looking for God, if he finds the Word, then he has found God. Because God is inseparable from His Word. They're one and the same. If you're looking for God in your affairs, you're looking to experiencing God, then really you should be looking to the Word of God. It makes the difference. You cannot have the Word and not have God. That's the way it is. So in the beginning, Bible says, has been the Word, and this Word is God. And all things were made by Him, and there's nothing made that was made without the Word of God. Hallelujah. You know why I'm excited about this? It means that anywhere the Word of God is present, something is about to be created. Ha ha! Hallelujah! Anywhere you find the Word of God, something is about to happen there. And that's how I know that your life is about to change. I see a breakthrough in your affairs. I see the Word of God break into that which is yours and bring a new dimension to your life. Hallelujah. The writer of Hebrews puts it this way. Let's go there. Hebrews 4. Hebrews chapter 4. And it says in verse 12. Let's go there. It says, I read. It says, "The Word of God is quick." Ha! The Word of God is what? It's quick. What does that mean? In the normal use of that word, it means it is fast. Hallelujah. But the word quick actually means it is alive. It's not dead. It's a living thing. The word quick also means it is life-giving. Praise God. So the Word of God has a way of bringing life. It can bring... Oh, yes. I hear the Holy Ghost say, one looking at me right now, you're right where you are, watching me right now, you have a diseased organ, maybe your liver, your kidney, but I see that it's been diseased. Right now, the Word of God is coming to you to quicken you. You are healed in the name of Jesus. The Word of God is a living thing, and it gives life. And right now, the life of God is released to you. Oh God, I like that. So the Word of God is quick. Bible says, let me read that text again. It says, "For the Word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Hallelujah. So the word of God is quick. It is powerful. It is a living thing. It is tangible. It brings change. If you have the word of God, you have life. There's something about the word of God that brings transformation. Hallelujah. Anytime we need God, we should look for his word, because his word makes the difference. Can you say with me tonight, the word of God in my life is bringing change to my world. The word of God in me, inside of my heart, is giving life to every situation in my life. Hallelujah. Now let me show you something else. Let's go to the book of Isaiah. Oh yeah. Isaiah 55. Let's go there. And we're going to read one verse. Isaiah 55. Okay. Now let's see verse 11 of that text. And this is what it says. Look at this. We're looking at God's word. Praise God. The character of the word of God. Now in this text, it says, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. Hallelujah. He's saying that the word of God has left the mouth of God. This is the way it is. If God ever speaks, this is the character of the word of God. He says, so shall be my word that goeth forth out of my mouth. Look at this. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I send it. Brethren, the word of God, whenever it is released, it can never come back without accomplishing the reason why it was sent. Can't you see that if you have the word of God, truly you cannot fail? Because there's a character to the word. It never comes back without a good report. The moment God releases his word, it has to come back with results. If you take the word of God into your life, there must be results. There must be. You know, I've always wondered at the way God always spoke. Praise God. Let me show you what I mean. If we pick our Bibles and go to the book of Romans, chapter 4, let's go there. I want to show you this. I've always wondered at this. Romans chapter 4, let me just pick one verse, and verse 17 of that text. It says, watch this. As it is written, I have made thee a father of many nations. I want to pause there. God is talking to Abraham, and he says, I have made thee a father of many nations. The man he's talking to is advanced in age. The wife of this man, Sarah, has gone beyond menopause, if there's anything like that. Yet God is not saying, I will give you a child or make you. Instead, he says, I have already made you. I've always wondered, why does God always speak like it has happened? Brethren, the truth is this. Once the word of God is spoken, it cannot come back without doing it. And that is why whenever God is speaking, he speaks like it is done. It is over. I'd like you to know that you are healed already in the name of Jesus. I'd like you to know you are triumphant already, that you cannot be oppressed. The word of God to you is that change has come into your life and into your world. Who is a champion in this house? Give the Lord a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. I'll tell you. That's why God always spoke that way. Always in the past tense. I've made you already. You're already a father. Hallelujah. You're already blessed. You're already triumphant. Hallelujah. You're already a rich man. I said, you're already a rich man. Woo! Glory. We're entering some unusual realms of God's power. I tell you, you know, I kept looking at the scriptures, and I looked at men like Moses. What made Moses go to Pharaoh, the most powerful king on earth, without an army, and he was bold to stand before him? What made Noah build an ark for over 100 years when the entire world believed the opposite, that it will ever rain like that. Hallelujah. Nobody believed Noah, but Noah kept building. He kept building and kept preaching. What made him do that? What made Joshua, intending to take a city, to march around that city? Hallelujah. We all know you don't destroy a city by marching around it. What made him do that? People of God, every man that received the word of God became unusual. In the face of opposition, they kept doing things that were strange. You see a man like David go to meet Goliath with a sling and stones. Who does that? Hallelujah. I tell you the answer. The one with the word of God. Hallelujah. Something about the word of God gave them unusual courage and boldness and faith. They dared to do things that will make anybody tremble. Look at Rahab, for example. Against the peril of her life, she began to entertain and keep the spies. Hallelujah. Look at Ruth, for example. Left her homeland to an unknown place. Unusual behavior. All of these men did that because they had one thing, the word of God. Hallelujah. I'd like to ask you a question today. What kind of word of God do we have today that in having it, while living in anxiety, in worry, in frustration, in unbelief, in fear, we can quote scriptures, yet we're in fear? What kind of word of God is that? Now let me ask you a further question. Abraham left his homeland because he had the word of God. He did an unusual thing. But let me ask you a question. If Abraham had the word of God, did he have the scriptures you have today? The answer is no. So what exactly is the word of God? Hallelujah. Abraham had the word of God. He did something phenomenal. He left his homeland all because of that word. Praise God. Today we have the scriptures and we can't even dare to stand for it. Abraham did not have the Bible. Praise God. Yet he had the word of God. So the question is this: what exactly is the word of God? Because the word of God in the life of a man will give him triumph and he will become an unusual person. Praise God. As we go on with this conversation, we're going to look into all of this. Praise God. Because the word of God makes a difference. Praise God. We have the scriptures, but does that mean we have the word of God? That you can quote a verse of the Bible, does that mean you have the word of God? Noah, did he have the Bible? The answer is no. He had no scriptures, yet he had the word of God. So what is the word of God? Praise God. Well, like I said, we're looking into the reality of the word of God because the word of God will make a difference in your life. Praise God. Now let's go to John chapter 1. Let me show you something about God's word. John chapter 1, one verse, and that will be verse 14. Look at this. Verse 14 says, it says, the word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father. Now look at this. It says the word was full of grace and full of what? Of truth. Praise God. So this verse of scripture tells us that where the word of God is present, there are three things that mark it. One, there will be glory. There will be truth in that place. Praise God. Truth, grace, and glory. Hallelujah. These three things are brought by the word of God. Hallelujah. Amen. A man that has the word of God has the glory of God around his life. And he has come into truth. Many things that confront us are lies. Are you listening? The word of God is the truth. When you have the word of God, you have the truth. And grace is brought to you because of the word of God. You know, brethren, the truth is this. Many good things that we come our way are not things that in our own selves we deserved. It is the work of grace. Jesus deserved it for us. Hallelujah. And by the word of God, we enter into grace. Many disqualify themselves. They tell themselves, I'm not good at this. I'm not qualified enough. I'm not yet ready to experience this. But know that the word of God, if you contact it, will bring grace into your life. Hallelujah. Can you look at your neighbor tonight and say, I qualify. Jesus qualified me. The word of God is bringing grace into my life. I'm ready for the unusual in my life. Even things that men feel I don't qualify for, I'm coming into them. Hallelujah. The word of God brings grace into our lives. It brings reality, a new reality. That is the truth. Hallelujah. And you will see the glory of God. I see that God is taking us into his beauty and glory. Hallelujah. The word of God will do that. The word of God will do that. And I want to read one more text to you for today. And we're looking at the word of God, because the word of God makes us champions. Hallelujah. It changes the trajectory of our lives. I give God thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. So let's go to 1 John chapter 1. And I want to read from verse 1. Look at this. It says, that which was from the beginning, in other words, it has always existed. There's nothing that predates it. Hallelujah. Before anything came, it was already there. That which was from the beginning, which we have heard. So the word of God can be heard. And it says, which we have seen with our eyes. So the word of God is a reality that we can see. Brethren, if you have not heard it, if you have not seen it, ask yourself if you have contacted the word of God. I see a revolution in your life in the name of Jesus. Something you are about to hear, something you are about to see, is about to cause an explosion in your life. That which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked upon. And it says, our hands have handled the word of life. Hallelujah. The word of God is tangible. It is real. It's a living thing. Hallelujah. You can relate with it. Just like your neighbor is real to you, you can describe your neighbor. The word of God is describable. Hallelujah. It's a living thing you can touch. And you can see it, and you will never be the same again. No man sees that word and believes that he can be sick. No man looks at that word and believes he will be oppressed. You cannot be defeated if you touch the word of God. Here, John says, it is the word of life. You can't handle the word of God and handle death. They don't go together. Hallelujah. They cannot be in the same place. The word of God brings life. So he says that the word of God is tangible. Let me read one more verse. He says, for the life was manifested, and we have seen it, and we bear witness and show unto you that eternal life which was with the Father and was manifested unto us. And look at this. That which we have seen and heard declare we unto you, that you may also fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. People of God, this word of God is not an exclusive thing for a few people. Are you listening? Everybody is invited to come into this place. It's a noble fellowship. I see changes in your life, and I see breakthroughs in your endeavors. Father, thank you. Thank you. We're going to continue this study next week. Praise God. But I'd like you to know that the word of God makes the difference. Hallelujah. It's a tangible reality. Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you in the name of Jesus. Open our eyes to see your word. Cause our ears and our hearts to know you, to know the word of God. Lord Jesus, cause every heart to receive that word that will make a difference. And so I take the authority of that word today, and I speak into your life in the name of Jesus. The hold of sin and sickness is broken over your life. Today,
Today I call forth your liberty, and I command the grace of God, the truth of God, the glory of God to fill your life. I declare that you are a champion and a victor in the name of Jesus. Oh God, thank you for your mercies in Jesus' name. Give the Lord a shout of praise today. Hallelujah. Blessed be his name. Next week, Wednesday, we are going to continue to talk about the word of God. Praise God. And I know that God is putting something into our lives that will make our world answer to us in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Next week, Wednesday, will be a communion service. Hallelujah. Get ready for that. It's a supernatural event. Hallelujah. So get ready for that. Blessed be his name. Now, I know some of you have paid your tithes, given your offerings. I'd like to pray for you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for everyone who's paid their tithes in serving you, in worship to you. In the name of Jesus, I release mercy and grace to you that you will walk in his divine provisions in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. You're blessed in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Well, with Jesus' joy, let's receive Pastor Johnson around to take the announcements for today. Give the Lord a big hand. Hallelujah.
Jesus.